So this is an overall brief picture that I have given. So this is one of the sales drop analysis. Then moving forward, so activities which curb financial impact. So these are certain suggestions I want to give from my side, where you can, I would not say you can completely curb your financial impact, but what I would say is that at least you can minimize your financial crisis. So the first one, as such, is own financing should be viable. So as such, like you might be thinking, since there is an issue or since there is a COVID-19 pandemic that's going on, you might think that after reopening, you might obtain for the enhancement of the OD or you might go for a term loan. Frankly speaking, the loans sanctioning has been completely come down by 40% and it might go further down. So you cannot think of an enhancement of an OD or a sanction of a term loan at this point of time. If it is sanctioned or if it is enhanced, it's well and good. But I would suggest own financing should be viable. At this point of time, you should think your own financing. Own financing, I mean your personal reserves or the financing that can be borrowed out of your relatives or friends. So that should be one of the things that should be viable. That might minimize your financial impact. I would say don't emphasize or don't focus that OD enhancement or sanction of term loan would happen. Assume that it would not happen and try to make your own financing viable. Then the second one I would suggest is cash conversion period needs to be reduced. The second important thing that you need to see yourself is that cash conversion period. So cash conversion period, I mean that from the payment to creditors, to the amount received from the debtors, the entire cash conversion cycle should be reduced because of the liquidity issue, because of the cash crunch that's been running in the economy and that will run in the economy in next 2 months. You need to make sure that the cash conversion period should be reduced. So whatever you pay to the creditors and whatever you receive from the debtors, the entire working capital cycle period has to get reduced. So this is one of the major criteria you need to focus right now. So that once you reduce that, that might add more. I mean, or that might minimize your financial crisis in the business. Then the third one is inventory management. So inventory management right now is very, very, very important because the thing is that the entire supply chain has been disrupted because of this COVID-19. So since the supply chain has been disrupted, you need to make sure that your raw materials you are receiving on time, your packing materials you are receiving on time, so that you can deliver your final products to the customers or to the clients on time. So since the supply chain has been disrupted, be on top of inventory management. Try to procure as many raw materials as possible. Try to procure as much as packing materials as possible. Inventory management, I would not only mean the supply chain disruption, but also you need to think the demand in the market you have estimated 2 months back might be completely different of what demand would you be getting currently. Because of this COVID-19 disruption or COVID-19 pandemic, the demand what you have expected might not be the same in next 3 months or 4 months or 6 months, whatever the impact is going to be. So you need to rethink like what would be the demand in the market, and accordingly you need to start planning your production. And as Sachli said, since there is a supply chain disruption, be on top of it for the inventory management. That's the third thing. Then the fourth thing I would suggest is optimizing and revisiting your variable cost. Now, you might be having n number of variable costs. So you just need to see where all you can optimize your variable cost, where all you can revisit your variable cost. If you have six, seven variable costs, essentially, okay, I can give you an example of a packing material. Let's say in a manufacturing sector, let's say instead of using one packing material, if you use other packing material, probably it is enhancing the quality of the packing material, which might go up. But currently, you might revisit that situation. You can use a cheaper quality packing material, or you can think of other variable cost optimization, which might not impact currently because of this situation. So these are the things you can think of, either optimizing your variable cost or revisiting your variable cost. Is the variable cost really relevant? Is the variable cost only enhancing? So these things you can revisit and optimize. Then the next one, delay in the capital investment plan. So This is again depending upon your personal finances. But frankly speaking, if there are any capital investment plans, either it might be renovation of your furniture or your office, or it might be opening of a new branch, or it can be diversification of new business, or it can be investing into the manufacturing, investing into the machinery for you to start new products or anything. If there are any such kind of capital investment plans that's been there, try to start delaying it. Because the thing is that because there might be a cash crunch that might be coming into the economy in recent times, and if you start investing on the capital, it might disrupt your current business. So try to delay your capital investment plans. Then the next one is delay payables for non-core business expenses. Right now, due to this COVID-19 impact, what I would suggest is that you can start delaying your non-core business expenses. So I would categorize the business expense into two things. One is the core business expenses. Without that expenses, you cannot run the show. And the other one is the non-core business expenses, with which even if those are delayed or if they are not there, that can be manageable. So if you can bifurcate your business expense into two things of core business expense and non-core business expenses, try to delay the payments of non-core business expenses and try to pay or clear the dues of the core business expenses. This might minimize your financial crisis that's there in your business. The next one is expedite your receivables. So we might be having a lot of receivables, and right now for everyone it is the correct time, and it's the situation for everyone to tell that due to COVID-19 I cannot pay now. So there might be any number of reasons that might be true or that might not be true, but you need to try expediting your receivables. You need to start collecting your receivables as much as possible, because there might be a because of this COVID-19, there is a liquidity crisis that is going to come in the economy, and because of which it might disrupt your business a little bit. So expediting your receivables, since this is the right time, everyone is on lockdown, so try to expedite your receivables as much as possible. Then the next one is conversion of your fixed into variable cost. So this is one of the things that you can see yourself, whether is there any fixed expenses that you can convert into variable cost. So as such, I can give you a simple example. Let's say you're in a rented premises and paying a rent of 2 lakhs. Now, 2 lakhs is a fixed expenses. Now, can you move to some kind of co-working space? If you can move to some kind of co-working space, because in co-working space, you will be paying per seat cost. So is it something you need to look into? So conversion of your fixed cost into variable cost, because variable cost will be spent only when required, but fixed cost is spent even if you require or don't require. So that is the reason there might be any number of costs which are fixed to you. Try converting them into the variable cost. That's one of the things. And the other thing where you can look into is that right now your entire bandwidth of employees might not be fully occupied, might not be 100% utilized. You can start thinking whether these employees can be used for any other activity that you might be planning in future, or these employees can be used for any other new revenue streams that you're planning. So try to use your employee bandwidth as much as possible. So either for the new revenue streams or for the work that you might be asking him to do after 3 months or 4 months, that you can ask him to do now, or like the closure of books of accounts. So closure of books of accounts and audit. So for generally, cleaning of books is generally done during the tax season. Now this is a good time to do it. So you can utilize your resources for cleaning up of your books of accounts. So there are n number of ways where you can use your employees with 100% bandwidth, so that at least you would save the time of the employees at that point of time if you can utilize now. That's one way. And the last way is thinking of alternate revenue streams. So Since there might be a disruption in your business, it's a good time to think whether you can generate any alternate revenue streams and be helpful for you, or that can make you some quick money. If it can make some quick money, that will be useful for you in the current business. So these are the few things that we are suggesting from our end. I would not say this would completely curb the financial impact. At least this will minimize the financial impact that the businesses will face. Then the next one, RBI measures to save the economy. So RBI has taken certain measures to save the economy. So, as such, so if I take each and every point into consideration, so RBI has cut 75% basis point on the repo rate, bringing the repo rate to 4.4% as earlier of 5.15%. Now, what is this repo rate? Repo rate is something where banks can borrow money from RBI. So, what is happening is that banks can borrow money from RBI now at 4.4%. Earlier, they can borrow the money for 5.15%, but now they can borrow the money from RBI for only 4.4%. Now, the biggest question here is that since the interest rate has cut down by 0.75%, will banks will charge lesser interest rate to public? That is a bigger question that we will get, and I mean we'll get the answer of it only when once this lockdown gets over and banks will declare something. As suchly, from the last three times, RBI has cut down the repo rate, but banks has never given the reduced interest rate to the customer or the client. So we need to see whether the banks are getting at lower interest rate, whether the banks are going to transmit that reduced interest rate to public, where public can get benefited or not. Yes, we need to wait and. And the next one is a reverse repo rate. Reverse repo rate has been cut by 90 basis points. So right now the reverse repo rate is 4%. Earlier the reverse repo rate was 4.9%, and now it is 4%. This is also the same impact. They just want to reduce the interest rates. Then the next one is cash reserve ratio has been cut by 1%, now bringing it to 3%. So every bank has to maintain cash reserve ratio with RBI or the central bank. So as such, right now the cash reserve ratio was 4%, and it has been reduced to 3%. The reason is that so that since it was reduced to 3%, banks need to maintain only 3% cash reserve ratio with RBI, and 1% they can keep themselves and they can induce into the public. So the reduction of cash reduction ratio will induce liquidity into the market. So banks will have more money and they can induce that money into the economy. So that's the only reason for which cash reserve ratio has been liquidity infusion of 3.74 lakh crores by central bank via three steps announcement, LTRO, CRR and MSF. So I would not go in detail into what is LTRO, what is CRR, or what is MSF. But what I would say is that RBI is trying to infuse, or RBI is trying to put 3.74 lakh crores of cash into the economy by various ways, so that the entire liquidity is not disrupted. Because since everyone is afraid of the COVID-19 pandemic, the cash is not flowing in the economy. The only way the cash is flowing in the economy is only through the essential goods. So you're incurring expenses only to the essential goods. So there is an entire cash crunch that is being going in the economy, and an entire liquidity issue that's been going in the economy. To curb that, government is putting in 3.74 lakhs crores of cash into the economy just to stabilize the situation. Then the last one, it's a major relief to a lot of people that banks and other lenders like NBFCs, they have extended the repayment schedule by 3 months. So as such, you don't need to pay your EMI for 3 months. That has been given. That's a relief that's been given by the RBI. But here, the point to be noted is that even though your EMI, you don't need to pay your EMI for 3 months. You just need to pay the interest. So interest will keep on accumulating. You don't pay the EMI. So my suggestion, if you don't have any cash crunch, if there is no cash crunch that you are facing, please pay your EMIs, because what is happening is that even though you don't pay your EMIs, interest is getting accumulated. So if you have the cash, please pay the cash and pay your EMIs. If you don't have cash, or if there's a cash crunch, yes, this is an advantage, or this is a relief of 3 months that you can take, so that the NPA classification, I mean, it is out of the NPA classification. Now, the entire RBI measures to save the economy is only one agenda. Now, if you are not going to pay EMI, then bank will not have money. If bank doesn't have money, they cannot pay salaries, point number one. Point number two, they cannot give loans. So if they cannot give loans, then the new businesses will not open. So if they cannot pay salaries and if they cannot pay loans, it's the entire economy that is going to get disrupted. So that is the reason RBI has come up with giving 3.74 lakh crores of liquidity to the banks. So what they are doing is that they are giving 3.74 lakh crores of liquidity into the economy or to the banks. So then what will happen is that even though you don't pay EMI, they have enough cash to pay salaries, they have enough money to give fresh loans, so that the entire economy will keep on running. That's the only agenda behind this RBI measures to save the economy. Then coming to the next one, tax measures by government on COVID-19. So there are certain tax measures that government has given in order to get rid of this COVID-19. So that will be explained by my colleague, Kavya.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm K.S. Kavyashree, a chartered accountant and AVP in Guardian Consultancy Services. Here I'll majorly discuss about all the tax measures and the extension of due dates provided by the government, because as we all know, the finance department and every business will be busy and be stressful only because of one word called due dates. And that is the benefit which the government has given in various departments like income tax, GST and MCA. So I'll be discussing few. First being the income tax and TDS. Due dates for filing of IT returns for the financial year 18-19 has been extended to 30th June 2020. Previously, the due date was 31st March 2020. Now it has been extended to 30th June 2020. So you can file your returns before 30th June for the financial year 18-19. Having said that, there is no waiving off of the late fees or the interest that is being charged. So if there is any means through which you can file the return, it is advisable that you do it as early as possible, because there is no waiver of late fee or interest in this case. It's just the due date that has been extended to 30th June. Next, on delayed deposit of TDS, interest has been reduced to 9% per annum. Previously, the interest was around 1.5% per month, which will sum up to 18% per annum. But now that has got reduced to 9%. So if there is any delay in payment of TDS, it is advisable to do it now because the interest rate is reduced to that extent. Then scheme of Vivad Se Vishwas is extended to 30th June 2020. So any disputes in regard to income tax can be solved through Vivad Se Vishwas scheme in an easier manner, where there is waiver of interest and penalty and where you have to pay only the disputed tax and get the tax issues resolved. This was previously, the due date was 31st March 2020. Now it has been extended to 30th June 2020. All the investment benefits under the Income Tax Act, the capital gains or the Chapter 6A deposits, where you will get deductions in your income tax return, which will lead to tax benefits. Previously, this was supposed to be done before 31st March 2020. Now you can invest up to 30th June 2020 as well, meaning if you invest in any of the income tax benefit schemes, you will get the benefit for the year 2019-20, even though you do it post 31st March till 30th June 2020. Then the government has recently released a press notice saying that it will refund all the income tax, GST and Customs Act refunds immediately. In case of income tax, it is up to 5 lakhs, and in case of GST, it is up to 1 lakh. In case of GST, it will also include the MSME entities. So if there are any refunds that have been applied, that will be immediately released. This will include, this will increase the liquidity of the companies as such, and the money can be utilized for various business operations. The next is compliance from MCA and ROC aspect. There are various benefits given here as well. One is CARO new order applicable from financial year 2020-21. Previously, this was applicable for the financial year 19-20. Now it has been postponed. This will benefit all the company closing procedures and the statutory auditors. They need not apply the new CARO order. They can. They have to do it in the previous order only. For newly incorporated companies, there are few files, forms which are to be filed, like INC 20A. They are supposed to be filed within 6 months from the date of incorporation. Now it has been extended to further 6 months. That is, from the date of incorporation, you will have 1 year time limit to file all these forms which are to be filed. Then if there is a company director who does not comply with the minimum residency, that is staying in India, staying in the country for 182 days or more. Even if the director is not able to stay in the country for 182 days or more, this will not be treated as a violation. So even if he stays for a period less than 182 days, that will not be treated as the violation as such. Next is the GST. We'll see all the measures given, tax measures by the government in case of GST and the extension of due dates. Late fee for filing GST returns has been extended to 30th June 2020. So for all the returns that are to be filed for the period February, March and April, that is which you have to file it in the month of March, April and May, now the due date is 30th June. As we all know, GST returns, there is a lot of data which we have to put in, like the sales data, purchases data, and the gathering of data will be a problem given this given scenario. Hence, the due date has been postponed, extended to 30th June. So, till 30th June, if you are filing and if your annual turnover of the company is less than 5 crores, then there will not be any late fee, interest or penalty. But if your company's turnover, annual turnover is more than 5 crores, there will be no late fee and penalty, but there will be an interest at a reduced percentage of 9% per annum. Previously, this was 18%. So here there is a reduction, but there is no waiving off of interest for the companies which are having annual turnover of 5 crore. Then the opting of composition scheme. In the first year, first month of the year, there will be chance where you can opt for composition scheme and not regular scheme. But in this case, the due date has been extended to 30th June. So if you want to opt for composition scheme in the month of June, you can do that as well. With the provision was not given previously, but now there is. So the decision of the company whether it wants to go to regular scheme or if it wants to go to composition scheme with regards to GST can be taken till 30th June 2020. Then there is annual return for the financial year 18-19 that is to be filed. The due date for this also has been extended till last week of June 2020. There is no specific date such as due date given in this case. It's only mentioned that it is the last week. So we can assume that the last week is the due date. Then there are a few more compliance benefits provided. The due dates for issue of notice, intimation, filing of appeal, furnishing returns, sanctions, applications and other compliances by taxpayers, be it GST or be it income tax, if there is any notice pending for which you have to reply or if there is any appeal the company wants to make against the existing demands or if the company wants to raise any grievances or queries, the due date of which previously was 31st March 2020, has now been extended to 30th June 2020. So if there was any due date for filing any appeal, for example, if it was 31st March and if the date has been, you were not able to appeal it before 31st, now you can do it till 30th June 2020. Then there are two major benefits given by the MCA, which will benefit the companies to a greater extent, that being companies' fresh start scheme. Under this scheme, if you opt for the scheme, all the years in which the company had defaulted in filing any returns with respect to ROC, that is like AOC 4 or MGT 7, any annual report, any form, any director who has been the DIN who has been deactivated because of KYC, all those forms can be now filed with no additional fees as such. There will be only minimum fees for filing the form, that is the only fees that will be charged, and no additional fees at all. So this is a very good opportunity for all the companies which have defaulted previously, and this is not specific to one financial year. For any, if you have defaulted for any financial year, you can file it right now with no additional fees at all. Then there is moratorium for 1/4/2020 till 30th September 2020. There shall not be any additional fees for late filing with MCA. So if you have to file any form within this duration and if the due date has been passed and if you are filing any late return, there will not be any additional fees. This will be a very good opportunity for all the companies to get their status active and to file all the defaulted payments and all the directors in which all the companies in which the directors have been, the DIN have been deactivated because of default can now rectify that and can file it. Then there are other benefits also provided, that is like Aadhaar and PAN linking. So if you have not linked your Aadhaar and PAN, you can now link it before 30th June, which was previously 31st March. Then debit card holders can withdraw cash for free from any other bank's ATM. Previously, if you withdrew cash from any other bank other than the bank which you are an account holding an account for more than 3 times in a month, there were charges. But now you can withdraw it for free. There is no bank charges as such. Then if you are not able to maintain minimum balance due to cash crunch or because of COVID, there will not be any fees or any charges from the government for the period of 3 months, from the bank, sorry, for the period of 3 months. And there is reduced bank charges for digital trade transactions for all the trade finance consumers. So for all these trade finance consumers, if you are wanting to make any digital trade transactions, there is reduced bank charges, because of which the transactions will get easier and then you can make online payments easily, which will benefit the company at large. And then there are other measures which Ms. Nirmala Sitharaman has addressed and provided in her speeches. One such benefit the company can avail is the employer and employer contribution of Provident Fund will be paid by the government for the next 3 months. This can be availed by the company if the number of employees in the company are less than 100, and if 90% earnings of those employees is less than 15,000. So the salary of the employees, 90% of the employees within the company should have 15,000 as their salary. That is when you can take this benefit, wherein the PF will be paid by the government and not by the company. And the next benefit is the collateral fee loans under Deen Dayal Yojana. Deen Dayal Yojana is the scheme which will majorly concentrate on aiming the skill for rural youth, and then they provide jobs. In that case, previously the amount provided was 10 lakhs. Now it has been doubled, and the collateral fee loans will be under the scheme will be 20 lakhs. And under Mahatma Gandhi Employment Guarantee Scheme, the wage rate for the employees previously was 182 rupees per day. Now it is 202 per day. This is not just during the lockdown period. Even after the lockdown period, the same rate, which is rupees 102 per day, will continue. Then the last point is the government had sanctioned medical insurance cover of rupees 50 lakhs per person to frontline health workers. So for all the doctors, nurses, sanitation staff, paramedical medics, and all the other people, because they're risking their life for us in this crucial situation and are serving the country, they've provided a medical insurance cover of rupees 50 lakhs, which the staff can avail. The major conclusion out of all these tax measures and highlights, I would say, is that this is a good opportunity for all the companies to comply with all the regulations to all, like income tax, GST or ROC filings. If we had defaulted any, it is the right time to work on it and to be updated, because there is no additional fees as such. Thank you.
So guys, this is a presentation. Hope you liked it. If there are any questions, you can just put it on the webinar. We would like to answer. So, one of such questions that has come is what would be the tax benefits that are given to citizens as well as the corporates? To answer this question, for the individuals or for the citizens, the tax benefit that has been given is nothing as such. The only benefit that they have given is that if you have failed to procure a life insurance policy, or if you have failed to procure a medical insurance, or if you are unable to make the deductions of that ATC or ATD or as such, that you can do before 30th June, where you can claim that as a deduction. Apart from that, for citizens, there are no such tax benefits. For corporates, to answer the question, yes, there are certain tax benefits that have been given. I would not say tax benefits. I would say extension of the tax. So they have deferred the payment of the tax. So government is not waiving off its own revenue. What it is doing is that it's only waiving off, or it is only deferring its revenue So instead of getting everything paid by 31st March, it's just getting deferred to 30th June. So TDS, you can pay before 30th June, but the interest rate has been reduced to 9%. And GST, they have, if the turnover is less than 5 crores, the GST can be paid before 30th June. So these are the few things that tax benefits that corporates are getting. Okay, so one more question. Which industry, according to you, will be picking up with this situation, and which industry would be largely impacted? If you ask me a question, which industry would be largely impacted? Anything related to tourism, travel. I mean, I would say anything related to hospitality, tourism, travel is going to get hugely impacted. And any companies which are serving this tourism or aviation or hospitality industries are also going to get impacted. Let's say you have built a software for some tourism company. That is also going to get impacted. Or you have built a software for some hospitality industry. So that is also going to get impacted. So the tourism, travel, aviation, and partly the labor intensive segments. So the labor intensive segments in the sense like construction business, I would not say construction business would have a huge impact. At least they would have impact currently. And again, it will pick it up in 3 months. So these are the industries that has a large impact. But if you ask me which is picking up, the industries that are picking up very well is gaming industry, e-gaming industry. E-gaming industry has picked up drastically well. If you see the Rummy, the Rummy gaming, or if you see the other gaming like Ludo or whatever the e-gamings are there, that has picked up drastically well. And I would say all the essential goods manufacturing sectors are also picking up very well. So one more question, how is the impact for IT and banking industry? The impact of IT industry, see, as such, we cannot assess the impact on IT industry because the impact of IT industry will depend upon the US market. The US has already started laying off the employees, and as such, there is a economic crisis that's been going in the US post, because what is happening is that if we see today, everyone are being normal because we are spending our reserves. Now, the biggest question that comes is that after reserves, what will happen? So once the reserves get expired, that's when we start thinking to save money. That's when the purchasing power parity of the consumer comes down. That's when all the other things will come. So if you ask me, as such, the impact of the IT industry, it again depends upon the US. There is a huge impact that's been there. And if you ask me on the banking industry, what is the impact? Even till the recent times, people are paying interest. They're telling at least 50% of the people are paying interest and EMIs. Since there's a lot of liquidity measures that's been taken by the RBI, so banking sector is survived for time being, but there is an impact, but I think they can recover because of the RBI measures that has been taken. The next question is that, will there be any risks of job cuts in the sectors? Yes, there is a risk of job cuts in the sector. Especially like if the lockdown is going to extend, what they have told is that there are 15 lakhs of unemployment or 15 lakhs of layoffs that's going to happen in US. And if the lockdown is going to extend, 30 lakhs of layoffs is going to happen in India is what has come out. Especially I cannot comment on it, but that's been estimated. Okay. So due to the reduced supply of goods and services, the prices may increase. Releasing additional funds will increase the trouble as the purchasing power will increase. Okay. So the question, I will repeat the question. Due to the reduced supply of goods and services, the prices may increase. And by releasing additional funds, it will increase, the purchasing power will increase. So to answer this question, the purchasing power is not going to increase because the entire economy is in crisis. The prices might come up in order to survive, but purchasing power is not going to increase because if you see the business owners are spending money without generating revenue, and government is spending money without generating revenue. Revenue is taxes. So essentially, the purchasing power of the customer will come down, or the client will come down. There are salary cuts that's being given to the employees. So because of that, the purchase power parity will come down. Or there's a huge unemployment that is being expected. Because of that, also purchasing power parity might come down. So the purchasing power will not increase as such; it will decrease. But however, there might be increase in prices that we need to wait and see. Okay. Would you recommend investing in mutual funds in this pandemic situation? If you ask me, is this the right time to invest in the mutual funds? Yes, this is time to invest in the mutual funds. Because the prices have come down, and you will not be able to buy this cheap again. I cannot forecast or foresee anything that you can buy the stocks, the shares or the mutual funds at this dead cheap rate. So yes, this is a good time to invest in the mutual funds. Now, is the situation going to get worse, where the stock prices are going to come down, or the mutual fund prices are going to come down? That I cannot comment right now, because that again depends on certain situation. As such, if we see today, the market has moved up. So, will there be any income tax holiday for startups and SMEs for a period of a year or two? Frankly speaking, I am not expecting any income tax holiday for startups or SMEs. I know there is a huge impact that's been there in SMEs. There is a survey that says that if this lockdown continues, 20% of the 20% of the SMEs, I am not even talking about startups, 20% of the SMEs are going to get eroded if this lockdown continues. So I would not expect a tax holiday, because as such, the government also is in need of funds. I know government should help, but I am not, as such, there is no news as such, but I am not expecting it. Then, so how will the job market affect in the economy? How shall the HRM and consultants all the HRMs and consultants needs to take care. We cannot estimate as such. I cannot give an answer for this, because as suchly we need to see, because what is happening is that I would say this in a two parameters. Anything that is essential for a company, that they will spend right now. Anything that will enhance the performance of a company, that they would keep aside. Like if I would just give an example, I might be partially correct. Let's say marketing. People might not spend more money on marketing, or people might not spend more money on HR softwares, because they internally need to spend money on the things that are essential for them. Marketing, for some of the companies, marketing will enhance the product, enhance the sales. That companies might opt for marketing, or other companies might think that we will keep the marketing aside for a few months and then again start. That might be the thing. And even the HR softwares, people might think that right now, let's spend this money for some other purpose rather than coming to the HR software right now. So essentially, that again depends upon the behavior of the people. But frankly speaking, whatever the essential expenses are there, those will be expended first. And whatever the enhancement of the performance or enhancement of the productivity, these are there, might take a step right now, but it will boost up in next 3 to 4 months once the economy recovers. So essentially, if there are any other questions, I hope I haven't missed. Okay, there are certain other questions also. Will this impact petroleum industry? The oil prices might come down. The oil prices might go up. Yes, this might have. This will have impact on the petroleum industry as well, because wherever we are importing the oil from, there is a crisis, and they will increase the petroleum prices. There will be a huge impact on the petroleum. Then. Uh, I hope I haven't missed any questions. If there are certain other questions. Do you advise to go abroad for masters at least for 2 years from now, as the global economy is dipping drastically? What do you think students who are about to graduate should do now with the situations arising in India and other countries as well? This is a question which I cannot answer because that's not my area of expertise. But what I would say is that the people who are graduating right now, because they are laying off people, there might be a small hassle that people would face. But essentially, since that's not my area of expertise, I cannot answer for it. Any special coding or in costing of a product should be considered due to COVID impact, say treating it as an abnormal loss or anything. Any specialized accounting or in costing of a product should be considered due to COVID impact. See, what will happen is that the abnormal loss, if you ask me, is there an abnormal loss that you would be taking into accounting, is the impairment of assets. So what would happen is that because of this COVID-19, it's for you, if you are an accounting professional or anything, for you to rethink whether is there an impairment loss for an asset or not. Because as actually impairment loss again depends upon the what is the amount recovered from that asset. So the recovery might come down because of this COVID impact, because you might not able to produce that many products and there might not be a recoverable amount for the asset. So the only such thing as of now I see as an abnormal loss that you need to see is the impairment of the asset. So is it understandable that CapEx needs to be postponed as we would expect a cash crunch? However, what is your take on the inflation in the near future on account of expansionary measures by RBI? So I'm just reading out the question. So it is understandable that CapEx needs to be postponed as we would expect a cash crunch. However, what is your take on inflation in the near future on account of expansionary measures by RBI? So, what is going to happen is that if there is a cash crunch with the businesses can do two things. Either they can take a loan or they need to increase the prices. If they are going to take a loan, banks should sanction a loan. It again depends upon the banks whether they are going to sanction the loans as such. With the amount that is required, or they need to go on increasing the prices. So I would see a inflation effect that's going to come in near future. So I would not see because of the RBI measures. It might be because of the banks who might not sanction loan because there might be a liquidity crunch that might be coming. But as such, the RBI boosting money into the economy, it's a requirement rather than to save the economy. So that might have a small impact. But apart from that, the banking sector would play a much higher role in the inflation. I hope I have answered all the questions. If there are any questions, please post.
Hey guys, if you are unable to post any questions, please raise your hands so that we could take it directly from you.
I guess we are done with the questions. In case anybody would want to ask any more questions, you can either post them in the Q&A, we have a few minutes left, or you could directly raise your hand so that we can unmute you and you can go ahead with your question.
So in case if I have not answered any questions, because questions are coming so fast that if I didn't answer anything, please post the question again. I will try to answer that.
Yeah, and if you guys have any questions, we are dropping an email ID here that you can post your questions to, and Sitaram would be happy to address them.
Thanks everyone for the session. Hope you liked it. In case if you have any questions, you can just post on the mail that has been shared by the team, and I would love to answer.
Thank you guys. Thank you so much for attending this session. Hope it was useful and you could take some points home. As again,